Okay. So I've done some stuff. I have moved my desktop computer off of the desk, and I've moved things around, and I think I'm not complete yet. But the screen is a little bit more farther, because that's the proper term to say here. My display is much more further away from my face. So I'm hoping this won't be too bad. I was also kind of able to, with removing the desktop off the top of the desk and put it the desk under top. That's what I'm going to call it now, desk under top. That I now have a space heater at my legs that I can clearly feel coming up this way. But I can also, I've also got the lights kind of in a spot where it's, I don't know. I'm going to turn them a little bit more away from my face because it's a little bright. Now, the second problem I have is the webcam. All right, the webcam properties here I have a little bit of issues with. Clearly, I'm having more issues than I thought. So I wanted to get it to where my face isn't blown out. So I have a big problem with this stupid Logitech, and I think anybody who advertises or says that this Logitech C922 is a good camera, don't listen to them. Now it's actually bad. It's terrible, and I am really upset that I have been duped. Anyways, so what I want to do is take off the auto exposure, bring down the exposure, so that the lights are doing their job, right? But I can come in here and actually take and bring up the gain. Now, the problem, I'm glad that the exposure has been enabled to be available. It was not before, I think. So, barring all that, see, my face is not as bright. It's a little bit more brighter than I want it to be, and I don't know if I want to take the gain back down. See, that's a softer, that's more correct, I think, as far as like how it should look. So, there. That's, and the other part I hate is that here's the sharpness all the way down. This should not be a thing. This is sharpness is all the way down. So that means, let me find something to, here. Okay. That, when in focus, should be nice, clear, and sharp. Even with sharpness all the way down. That's the signs of a good camera. Now, the fact you have to turn the sharpness up to 128, and now everything is nice and sharp, that's the signs of a bad camera. Okay. That, and I think the sensor in this camera is not 1080p, I think the maximum of this sensor is actually 720p. I've changed it between 1080, 720, and you know, all the settings in between, and the best quality I can get out of it is 720, and this 1080 looks the damn same. Anyways, that's my that's what I'm doing. So okay, so I've got the gain. It looks like I'm good there as far as brightness, you know, right about that, right there. I'm happy with that. We'll let the white balance itself. That's fine. Exposure, I'm happy with. Focus. There. Whatever. That's zero. So, and the zoom, the control goes up to 500. But once you hit, let's see, 127, 128, I don't even think that far, it stops. Okay. Anyways, the whole reason why I wanted to kind of play with the camera and the exposure was because I wanted to kind of remove a little bit more of the background, make it so that it's you know, I hear those lights. And my eyes look like I'm too bright now that I've turned that up. So I'm going to open that back. Oh, boy. That is too bright. So let's bring down the colors. Let's bring it into orange. Oh, those lights are hot. I've had them on for a little long. Longer than I wanted to. Okay. That's fine. I think I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that. So now we're going to go back and we're going to... end main menu. We're going to exit out of this flight that I was kind of playing with. And we're going to do a new flight. Now that I've spent a good 6 minutes talking about camera settings. Which none of you saw unless you were paying attention to the little picture that I put up here. Because I've made it nice and small. So I'm not that intrusive, but you can still see my ugly face. Anyways. So I see that they've added some stuff on sale. The sale's not that great, it looks like. But it's also nighttime. So here's the real question. Do we want to do a nighttime flight? If we do a nice little nighttime flight, let's do something. So it looks nice and bright up here, right? How long is the flight from Los Alamitos to Vegas? Hour 23 in this guy. What if... I did change the sensitivity on the rudder pedals a lot, so it should be a lot better. Citation or longitude? CJ4 or longitude? We'll do the CJ4. It's not, you know, it's fine. Let's, and now, the half an hour flight. See, look at that. So let's do, oh, we could have done Long Beach. Let's do Long Beach. No, we want that parking. Go from this parking. Where's our taxiways? Because I want to go, I don't know. We'll let them figure it out, right? That's why we have. So we don't want this parking, that's for sure. We want something like here. Let's do Ramp 6. There we go. And then we'll figure out, we'll let McCarran International. I probably shouldn't come into McCarran International, but whatever. It's fine. You know what? No. Let's do Las Vegas. Okay. There we go. Not big boy airports. We're going to go into, you know, medium boy airports, right? That's what we are. So I did do a little bit of practicing, not a whole lot, but I did a little bit of practicing with the rudder pedals. I did change the sensitivity, so it should be a lot. Better. Sure. That's the word we're going to use. Better. Now, this is going to be a nighttime flight, so we're not going to get to see a whole lot outside of, you know, what we do from... your takeoff and all that. So, this will be interesting. I'm really hoping I don't crash it. I'm going to be, you know, trying to actually fly, and I might have to turn off the rudder pedals. I do have the rudder still on the flight stick. God forbid we call it a joystick. on the stick. So I'd still have the rudder control there if I want to take it over that way. But yeah. Okay. Again, it's a 23-minute flight. Which means, we all know this, it's going to be an hour long. And that's probably going to be because a good portion of that is going to be because I'm going to have a hard time with the rudder pedals. We'll see. Also, a good portion of this is apparently the loading screen here. Like, wow. What the heck is going on? Why is this taking so long? It's actually kind of shocking with how long this is taking. Am I? Oh. Thanks for letting me know. Okay, so we're not going to get, data streaming. And this guy's out here just kind of chilling. Cool. All right. Oh boy, I don't really know this aircraft that well, so let's hide the yoke, and we're gonna, I guess, start looking at things. Okay, that's your navigation. I don't know this aircraft very well. Beacon lights, okay. Yeah. Engine okay. I mean, that's easy. Starter engine. I mean, we want the starter engines, right? Yeah. Starter engines are on. Yeah. No. Don't worry about it. I got this. Mm-hmm. Flaps, throttle, brakes. It's big red button. Battery. Engine generator's on. I can't see. Engine generator's on. Look, if I've learned anything. Look for the big red button. All right, I do want to bring the flaps all the way down. Yep. All the way down. I want to bring the trim down. I don't want to bring the trim all the way down. Okay, so disengage starters. Yeah, I get it. Thanks. Okay. I get it. We'll start the starter back up. I don't know. Maybe there's a start setting. I mean, I'm sure this is all. I'm sure somebody's looking at me like, what are you doing? Ah, ignition. That's what we want. Fuel. We need those on. Oh, chill out. Run. Look at that. We do things. Look, I know how to do this. This is fine. I do this for a living. Alright, let's go to ground.
Long Beach Ground, Groom Tours Golf, Romeo 666, with Oscar request taxi to the active, departing straight out.
Groom Tours Golf, Romeo 666, taxi. To an all short of runway 30, via taxiway Alpha Delta Cross, runway 26 left hotel. Contact tower on 119.0 for when ready.
Taxi to and hold short runway 30 via taxiway Alpha Delta Cross runway 26 left hotel Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666.
All right, ground services. I'd like a pushback, please.
Long Beach Ground, Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666, requesting pushback.
Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666, pushback request accepted.
Then you're going to steer to my left, right?
Long Beach Ground, Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666 requesting pushback tug to steer the aircraft to the left.
So that'll steer the, my rear end of the aircraft to my left. No, no. Don't worry, this is still a 23-minute flight. There. Might help if I take the brakes off for you. Oh, look at this! We're doing it.
Long Beach Ground, Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666, requesting pushback tug to push the aircraft straight.
Groom Tours Golf Romeo.
Okay.
Your request has been transmitted to the operator.
Long Beach Ground, Groom Tours Golf Romeo 666, requesting the end of pushback.
I wonder how far they can push me back. They go through fences. Okay. Don't worry, dude. All right, let's go back. Clearance. All right, clearance. So I want to push the foot in the way I want to go. Oh, God, this is hard. Harder than I want it to be. Don't worry about that. But to me, and that kind of, like, doesn't make a whole lot of sense. And I've heard plenty of people complain that, you know, the... Oh, good, look, see, I'm going too fast. Maybe I should just kind of brake with this. Brake with my, I don't know. Oh, don't worry, dude. Just stay in the middle of the way I need to go. It's fine. And I love that, of course, the flight that I want to do that's going to be... Oh, alright. Yeah, to Vegas. Oh, boy, jeez. Running over some people here. I don't really like the rudder pedals, apparently. So I'm a little annoyed. So I don't like the rudder pedals. They ain't doing it for me. That's for sure. We're definitely going the long way around here. Oof. I don't know what the hell just happened. I ran over the terrain. That was terrible. That's not even fair. I'm gonna let them taxi out. Ugh, that's just ridiculous. That's stupid. Flight Sim, you can't even get out of the taxi. Thanks, Flight Sim. You know, Microsoft, if you're watching, this airport in Long Beach needs to be corrected a little bit. And here's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna go to takeoff. Yes, keep a lot of time. We're not far enough. See? How hard is that? That was not my fault. The ground was literally damaged.
Long Beach Tower, Grim Tours Golf, Romeo 666 at runway 30, ready for departure to the north.
Yes. Departure. We good? Or where's my comms controls? Yeah. It's all gone. Sure it is, of course. Why wouldn't it be? Crestwind. Okay, and then we should start getting to speed here shortly. There we go. And let's get up. Go. Oh, nice. No. Damn it. The trim setting, I don't like it. It's an absolute frickin' value on here. I cannot. So, I did not.
Long Beach Tower.
No, I did. And I actually acknowledged it, but you didn't accept it. Alright, let's trim down a little bit. Trim back up. I think the trim has been the sensitivity in the trim has been adjusted, so that's great. Maybe? I don't know. (sighs) my problem was is that that was a, that's the trim setting on here is absolute values. And by that I mean where it's sitting right now is negative 15%. The second I touch it again, it's still going to be at negative 15%, which means if I start a new game and I haven't set it to, you know, a trim value that is other than negative 15%, it's still going to be at negative 15%. If the computer thinks, oh, I'm going to set it to zero or whatever else it wants to, the second I try to adjust it, boom, right back to negative 15%. Anyways. That's my problem. I think we're technically allowed to fly this direction. The frickin' maps, I hate this. This is so frustrating. How all of the things here get moved around.
Descend and maintain 10,000 feet. Expect vectors. Visual runway tree. 1 left approach southwest. 2 tree by Snyder.
As we leave the San Fernando Valley? No. Is it? Yeah. Yes. We leave the San Fernando Valley. We go on to San Bernardino, I believe. This is where we're going to. And that would be... Yeah. Should be heading over San Fernando Valley. Valley. Shortly. Right over this mountain, yeah? Yeah, I think,
Alaska Mike 30, you are 1.5 miles east of Los Angeles.
Yeah, that's Ontario. Yeah, I know where we are.
Don't I?
Ontario International.
Descend and maintain 10,000 feet, expect vectors, visual runway tree, 1 left approach, skyway.
Yeah, this should be San Bernardino.
Why
is does it look like my graphics settings are low again? Oh, that's right, because it told me that I was not streaming it. That's great. My bandwidth was too low. Thanks, MediaCom. Okay, putting the computer underneath the desk is probably not the smartest idea. The higher we climb, the faster we can go. That's the 15 freeway in front of us, which should be heading to Vegas, and below us, is that Palmdale Road? I think that's Palmdale Road, I'm not sure. But basically, it looks like we're just kind of following the 15 freeway until we get to Vegas. So I can actually see it pretty well here on screen. I have no idea how it's coming out on the video. It looks dark in the video that I see in the preview. So, like, no idea if I could even see it. So hopefully it's a decent flight, not just completely. I'm gonna turn off my lights. Doesn't look like what I see. Oh well. That's interesting. It's interesting that it doesn't seem like it's capturing it right. Whatever. So that should be what's in front of us. So this should be Fort Irwin. Say Baker, but I know it's not Baker. Baker's a little further out. Barstow, yeah. All of my control sensitivity has changed. And I don't like it. So I added a, a USB, outlet thing. So I think all of my controls have changed. So, that's interesting. There's Harvard, if anybody's wondering. We do have Harvard in California here. I think I can actually see basically all of the city of the entire Nye County of, or whatever it is. What's the county of Vegas? Is it Nye County? I don't know. Anyways, looks like you can see the entire valley of Vegas right there. And I think. So right in front of us, right here, that should be Vegas. I believe that's going to be Pahrump, Nevada. And this should be Baker. This should be Fort Irwin. No idea. I think this is Fort Irwin. This should be Baker up here. That was, but it really made a loud sound. hell's going on here? So this should be, is this Baker? Are we over speed again? I hear it's over speed. Okay, where were we? That's Baker, look at me. Because we keep going down. Why are we going down? Because our trim is going down. Why is our trim down? Let's turn the trim up. Trim up. Trim's a little too high. Trim's a little too high. So then Death Valley is probably this marker right here. No. This is Death Valley out here. And this is going to be somewhere near, I think maybe further out. It's going to be like near the Armagosa Opera House. I'm hearing overspeed, but I don't feel like I'm going overspeed. Sounds quiet in here. Would be nice if we could turn on the AC. Level out here. Right now I'm hearing over speed again. But you know what? We're 60 miles. Yeah. Is that because they're closed?
Oh boy, I was kind of hoping that they would do give me a well, poop. Let's get the trim back up a little bit. All right. So that is my destination, isn't it? Ugh, get out of the way. Nobody wants you. Legs. Earth data. Good job. Flight plan. KVGT. That is what we chose. I wish this was a little bit more responsive. KVGT. North Vegas. Okay. So it doesn't have a tower. At least it doesn't have a tower that's open. No, it does.
North Las Vegas Tower Mentors Golf Romeo 666 is tree 9 or miles southwest flight level tree 50 with Oscar to land.
Mentors Golf Romeo 666 North Las Vegas Tower. Altimeter 29.87.236.17.
Little bumpy flight, little bumpy flight. We definitely don't want to put the flaps down at this speed. I don't think. Oh yeah, the engines are shut off for the most part. But I think we're doing alright as far as our descent. A little bit of wind. Back, slow down some. I don't want to fully extend the flaps, so maybe if I just... Oh. I guess we're gonna... Yeah, that'll work. I know, landing gear. Alright. I don't understand why the flaps work the way they do. Don't worry about how tight of turns I'm making. You just worry about where your drink is on my flight. Alright, clearly we're a little high in altitude. Right, clearly. We can always recover this. It's not that bad. So weird. It says that's too fast. And I feel like we're not even... I mean, granted, we're going fast. 253 nautical miles an hour is pretty frickin' fast. But we'll slow down. We've got it handled. Yeah, I was kind of paying attention to what I'm doing here. My bad.
Clear to land runway, 25 Grim Tours Golf, Romeo 666.
Just zoning out. Sounds like, put your landing gear down. Why haven't you put your landing gear down? You seem like you want to land. Don't you want to land? Green. is that light green? That's so weird. We know what we're doing. We have landed multiple times. Oh boy, this is kind of a short runway. Tell me this does not look like a short runway. This looks like a short runway. I'm just saying. Okay, that's a little intense there. Gear is coming down. I'll do what I can to get to a parking spot, I think. Let's see what happens here.
Las Vegas ground, Rim Tours Golf Romeo 666, request taxi to parking.
Rim Tours Golf Romeo 666, taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Charlie Cross Runway 30 right, Charlie Cross Runway 30 left, Charlie.
Taxiing to general aviation parking via taxiway Charlie Cross Runway 30 right, Charlie Cross Runway 30 left, Charlie Rim Tours Golf.
Whoa, 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 hey, whoa, 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 whoa. I'm turning here. I'm going straight here. Jesus. Oh, okay, now you tell me. Hold position of the traffic. That other traffic that already ran into me. Why am I holding to position? Why am I holding position for a gas truck? Like, could they have not waited? I'm just... Maybe they mean hold position here. Yeah, I'm just saying. Well, what are you doing? What is this? Why should I hold position for other traffic? I'm confused here. Yeah, I copy.
Roger, room tour is called Romeo 666.
Good enough. Oh man. Alright. Well, there we are. That was our beautiful flight. Let's turn the lights back on. Oh man. Phew. That was a beautiful flight from Long Beach to Las Vegas. Shut it all down. Mm-hmm, you're fine. Let's see here. Big red button. Filling with them. Yeah, 34 minute flight and a nice long hour video. But granted, I know, for like 15 minutes of it was me just kind of BSing. So, anyways, there we go. That was a nice flight. That was a pretty evening flight, night flight. That's what I was trying to say. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'll post this one up shortly. So, cool. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.